So the marching show this year is about kind of a couple days in the life of a performer.
Being drum major is a lot of work. That's what we're there for. Whenever things aren't going well, we try and be uplifting. We try and share our own experiences.
I know you mentioned that we didn't make it last year, which was disappointing for everybody. Part of the game sometimes. You know, sometimes it just doesn't work out the way that you want it to.
That crumbled up piece of paper, that judge sheet, just a piece of paper, and yet it meant the world to us.
Oh, it was really exciting. Anytime that you can make a finals at any contest, it's a big deal.
I was excited. I think the work that our band put in definitely earned us a spot in that finals performance.
My first reaction was definitely, thank God.
If our performance in any small factor, if it changed by a little bit, we could have not been in there.
The thing I love most is the people. There's nothing else where you just get to be with these people and just get to have a good time with them. There's nothing like it. There really isn't.
So the marching show this year is about kind of a couple days in the life of a performer. And you can kind of pick your favorite performer, whoever that is, you know, that's, you know, Taylor Swift, Lizzo, whatever. I mean, and kind of the journey that they go through on a day-to-day basis. You know, they have shows that they perform. Once that show is over, you know, they go through the hustle and bustle of getting to the next show. They've got, you know, news and fans and paparazzi and pictures and autographs and all that kind of stuff. So it can be a little bit crazy and hectic at times. And then, you know, we've seen through a lot of performers throughout history that even though they're very popular and they've got a lot of fans, that they can be very, very lonely, which is something that a lot of stars struggle with. So the show kind of goes through those three stages, and then ultimately gets to where, you know, you got to do another performance, you got to do another show. So they kind of get full circle again. The show ends a lot like it begins with another performance, you know, where the performer realizes that they do that because they love it and because that's something that they were born to do. And so that's kind of the nuts and bolts of the show.
Being drum major is a lot of work. I end up staying about 45 minutes to an hour after rehearsal ends each day, so it's definitely a big time commitment. It's a lot of work, but it's really a whole lot of fun. Being up there in front of the band, it's an experience like no other, and there are certainly days where I miss being a performer, but it's really cool being able to really see what the band is doing instead of just being a part of it and not being able to see the whole picture.
The mindset I think that every band member needs to have during warm-up is to have a very engaged, focused mindset. where nothing else really matters right now except for performing the best that you can. So whether that be, you know, calming yourself down with breathing exercises or mentally engaging with whatever the band is doing, I think that's most important, to be focused, to have a great performance. I don't think that band members really overcome their nerves. I think that nerves are something you kind of just embrace. And for me, that's helped a lot, like during performance when a lot of people are watching. I think I kind of just take it all in and realize that, you know, what I do is not really gonna impact these guys in a couple more days. You know, they're gonna forget about this performance or whatever. But I think really, like, just being able to take in the moment and embrace the nervousness, I guess, is what helps me during performance.
Oh, it's really exciting. Anytime that you can make a finals at any contest, it's a big deal. Every contest has different bands and different competitions. But I think I was really, really excited. I was proud of the kids. I was proud of that accomplishment. And that's something that a lot of bands don't get to do. A lot of bands don't make finals at a BOA contest. So I was very, very proud of it and very excited about us and getting a chance to perform in finals on that.
My first reaction was definitely thank God. I know it was stressful for us. It was also so hot on that field. My feet were burning in my marching shoes. It was an oven out there. But I was really relieved that we made it, and then also really excited, because having two performances in one day is always just a great opportunity. And I was really looking forward to the full retreat at awards.
I was excited. I was very excited. I think the work that our band put in definitely earned us a spot in that finals performance. I think that one thing that kind of stuck out to me was the fact that we made 12th place, which is right on the edge. If our performance in any small factor, if it changed by a little bit, we could have not been in there. But I think our band program used that as motivation to keep getting better. So that, you know, at future contests, we wouldn't have to worry about, you know, just barely making it. So, yeah, I was very excited.
There's two lessons from that. One, so be my girl. This season ass. You have to make the choice to remember tonight all too well.
Yes, sir.
The purpose of pre-performance speeches is to inspire different band members, as well as provide some comedic relief with funny stories or funny just ideas that we have, and kind of just, I think, get the band in an excited mindset so that when they go into the performance, they can really enjoy what they do.
So the purpose of the speeches that we do at each of the inspections before games and competitions, the main one is really to just inspire and encourage the band, honestly. That's what we're there for. Whenever things aren't going well, we try and be uplifting. We try and give positivity. We try and share our own experiences and how we feel about band in general in order to try and give a bit of our perspective to everyone else and really help them see that this is something really cool and let's work to make it even cooler.
Yes? I think the biggest difference between good and great bands is the dedication to being really great from the members and from the staff. I think once you get to like good and great, I think the skill level is very comparable. I think the ability level is really comparable. I think you get to a spot where everybody can achieve the same thing. It just, at that point, it breaks into who will and who won't achieve the same things. Like who can really buckle down when it's crunch time and be detailed and work really hard and get all the little things done that make bands great. I don't think that the band puts in more work than other activities. I think every activity probably puts in about as much time as they possibly can to be as good as they can. So I would not say that the band is like, oh my gosh, the band works way harder than this group or that group. I don't know that I would say that. I think that all groups work really hard. I can speak for the band because I work with them and I know that we put in a ton of hours with what we do. So I'm just really appreciative. And I guess it makes me appreciate all activities, you know, that really kind of put in a lot of time, because I mean, it is a lot. I know football puts in a lot of time, basketball, theater, choir, everybody does. It's just what it takes to be really good.
And now, in performance order, as determined by draw, the 10 bands that will advance to tonight's final round. In here. Performing at 9:45, the Dawson.
And I looked at our varsity roster, and over half of our varsity wind player roster are underclassmen. Over half are freshmen or sophomores. That's not been a thing before. Like, it's typically been mostly older kids that knew what to do, knew the routine, knew everything. Like, this is the first year that we've had to work through a really, really, really young group. And yeah, on top of that, we've had a couple of years prior to this that weren't normal years. It makes sense that this has been a different year. And it makes sense that some things took a little longer to come together. And it makes sense that some things took a little longer for everybody to get. Which did. But you did. And you did. And y'all have made, and what's amazing about that is, like, the end of this season, even with such young students, not any worse than anything else we've had. You're amazing. And you've been able to put together an amazing show. It's become consistent, and it's become awesome every single time I watch it. So that's a huge accomplishment to you all. And for all of you underclassmen, I'm so glad you're here. I'm glad you're here, and I hope you had a good year, and I hope you enjoyed this.
The dog tags to me represent the accumulation of all my hard work through my 4 years of band. So after every marching season, we get a new one, and now being a senior, I've collected four, and it just reminds me of the ridiculous hours that I've put into this program, and is a real testament to whatever show we had. So my freshman year was Unveiled, then The Sixth Sense, then Acceleration Z, and then finally Mercurial World. So it has the name of the show on it, and the year, representing a year where I put in a lot of work and effort into the program.
The dog tags, to me, they really mean a lot. They are tangible proof that I did it, I was there, I put in the work, I put in the hours, and I did it. And I did it with everyone else. Everyone else who I marched with has those dog tags too. And they're really a symbol of overcoming adversity, pushing through it, getting it done, and knocking it out of the park.
Everybody by now should know marching season is tough. What's even more difficult than marching season? Two marching seasons. Even more difficult than that? Three marching seasons. Which brings me to my last group. Seniors, I remember every one of you when you got here. Every one of you. I remember what you were like. I remember the ones that you kind of look at it and you're like, all right, someday that kid's going to be leading the program. Some of you, if you look at it, like, that's going to be a solid man kid. Some of you, like, you're like, I don't know if that kid's going to make it. We know, right? We know that we've all had people that have fallen along the way. And I've seen, like, anytime somebody asks me what's my favorite part of the job, I have to think about it. My favorite part of this job is watching you seniors come in as freshmen, as little kids, just big junior high kids, let's say it that way. You're just big junior high kids. And watching you become adults. And watching you go through that growth where you go from just a little kid to, like, be having, like, relationships and having, like, driving and getting, like, And then getting ready to watch you guys live here and to be wonderful people that contribute to this world and to our society. And I'm so, so proud of all of you seniors. And as seniors, I hope that your time here with this program, that you feel it's been worth it. I hope that you feel that you not just learned those rhythms and steps and shows, but I hope that through your work here, your time in this program, you learn things that you can carry with you for the rest of your life. Like, I know what hard work is. I know what perseverance is. I know what it's like to face a challenge and not give up. I know what it's like to face a difficult, like, yeah, I've, like, man, got all these hours, I've got all these homework, I don't know if I can do it, but yes, you can. And those are things that you'll take with you forever. Those of y'all that are leaders in this program, your leadership here will help you be a good co-worker and a good leader when you leave here. So I hope that you've enjoyed your program. I've enjoyed it. Seniors, I love everyone. And I appreciate all the time that you've brought to this program. And we wouldn't be here without you. God bless the legacy. When y'all are gone, this program, you will have left the program better than when you got here. And I appreciate you so, so, so very much. So seniors, thank you.
With that being said, seniors, get up here and get number four.
Congratulations to the Clear Lake High School Band, Brazoswood High School Band, Clements High School Band, Clear Falls High School Band. In sixth place, to the Shadow Creek. In fifth place, the Clearbrook High School Band. In fourth place, to the Stephen F. Austin. In third place, the Dickinson. In second place, and advancing to the state marching band contest, congratulations to the Dawson.
Yeah! Yeah!
Advancing to the state marching contest by making second area was really exciting for me as well as the entire program. They only take five to state, and so to make not only just make it, but to make second and with a comfortable lead there, that was really exciting. I think it was a real testament to how much hard work we put in the week before, improving our show as much as we did. And it was nice to see just success, you know, people seeing our hard work, having that shown on the judging sheets. So.
The area awards ceremony, it was really just fun. When we were after our area finals performance, when we were walking off, I was giddy. I was just happy because I was like, we did it. We knocked that out of the park. We did great. So walking into awards, I definitely had some anxiety, but really I was pretty satisfied. Hearing the results was definitely a relief after last year. But once they called sixth place and I knew we had locked it in, that was, felt good. And just even getting second place, it was good.
I was very, very happy. Relieved, of course, like I know you mentioned that we didn't make it last year, which was disappointing for everybody. Just, you know, part of the game sometimes. You know, sometimes it just doesn't work out the way that you want it to. But I feel like the kids, especially at the end of the season, did a really, really great job. With that last push, getting a lot better, and seeing that our results, like that we came out second area, was a very big relief, and I was very proud of everybody for that.
The one thing I love most about band is making music with my friends. Two very important things to me. I have a lot of friends that happen to play music and they happen to be really good at it. And so it's exciting, you know, drawing from each other and really just creating beautiful music that I really enjoy playing and other people enjoy listening to.
I think the thing I love the most about band and marching band and high school band is all of the real life applications that come from this activity that carry on past high school. You know, I know kids have to go to high school and they have to learn stuff. They have to learn math, they have to learn English, they have to learn stuff to make them, you know, not dumb. I mean, we can't have an uneducated society. So I know that's important. But I think that there's a lot of lessons that are learned here at band, also in athletics and other extracurricular activities that teach kids how to live and how to be productive citizens past basic knowledge, like how to work with others, how to overcome adversity, you know, not making state one year, making it the next. Like how do you deal with disappointment and overcome disappointment the next time that you have an opportunity to, you know, to do better. I think there's a lot of things that kids will take from them that they maybe don't realize right now. They may not realize next year, but eventually they'll start to kind of put that together. It's like, oh, I figured out how to do this in band. You know, I figured out how to be a good employee, how to be a good boss, how to be a good leader. All that can kind of be tied back to band. So I think that's probably what I love. I like notes and rhythms and, you know, marching shows. That all that's cool. But I think the real life application of this activity is probably what I love the most.
I love band. The thing I love most is the people. That's all it is. There's nothing else where you just get to be with these people willingly or unwillingly for up to 20 hours a week. And just get to have a good time with them, put in the work together, enjoy it. There's nothing like it. There really isn't.